Let's try that again. 0348, are you in there?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right, go ahead, brother. What do you need?
Since the last caller was mentioning his Facebook page, I'd like to also mention I run the American Patriot Coalition on Facebook. That's facebook.com/AmericanPatriotCoalition. I go by the Conference Pass. We're a page dedicated for the Constitution, Second Amendment, constitutional abiding Leo and EMS and fire. And so if anybody wants us to come support that page, we will definitely, you know, appreciate that, any like-minded individuals.
You're definitely on my list of things to do, man, and I appreciate you chiming in. So you administrate that page?
Yes, sir. Me and a couple other admins.
What's your reach right now, if you don't mind me asking?
We've got about 3,000 fans on that page.
That's a good chunk. I'm going to go ahead and support you a couple more times while we're going through this endeavor. American Patriot Coalition, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's 52 people on Facebook. Just heard you say that. Or, I'm sorry, 52 people on this call. Just heard you say that. So hopefully you get some quick ads and other people use you as a resort. Would you be biased to maybe letting some people use that as another avenue of communications?
I'd like to do that. I just don't have my laptop available right now, but maybe tomorrow I'd be able to stream this conversation.
Yeah, I would highly recommend trying to do that. That would help. But, you know, also, you know, with the kind of reach that you do have, if, you know, more leaders are showing up at your page, if you could start compiling, you know, some of these other administrators that are trying to help out as well. You know, you've got a very broad name of your group, American Patriot Coalition. So hopefully more people, you know, move towards you and, you know, meet up there, you know, for other further communications. We are trying to get Patriot Underground to, you know, help out and offer their page to help out with rideshare. So I think
that
maybe
would,
the next...
I would like to help out, yeah. And if you could send me a message through your personal Facebook onto Patriot Coalition, I could link up with you that way and we could keep going back and forth, exchanging information and content.
Absolutely, absolutely. I will get to that. Again, you're on a long list of things to do, man. I've got you here now somewhere in the middle with a list of other people I need to add as well as their pages and things. So I will get to you, man. Forgive me if it's not, you know, until tomorrow night. You know, I'll get to it when I can. I appreciate you chiming in. But on a personal level, if you want to type in BLYAN and then space free the people, all one word, I should pop up. And
what was that first part?
Brian's my first name, BLYAN, and then the words free the people, all one word. I will pop up, and I'm at maximum capacity right now, but if you want to throw me a follow, you know, that's one way to start off. And then, you know, I leave my profile pretty public. You can chime in, and then we'll reconnect from that point. How's that sound?
All right, cool. Is your picture the thing from the office, the if you could avoid starting World War III, that one?
Yeah, that's me.
That's funny. Okay, thanks.
That would be nice, okay?
All right, thank you.
And then when you get back to me, make sure you just change the covers of your TPS reports to blue.
Okay. Thank you.
And that's only for people that saw the office. All right, we got one more people. Two more people. I apologize. I'm going to cut you loose, 0348. I'll report back when you get a chance, okay, man?
All right, thank you.
I appreciate you, bro. Next caller ending in 1008.
Yeah, I'm here.
Go ahead, brother.
I'm hailing from the 661 Kern County in California. Is there any reports that I don't remember the website exactly, but is there any reports of someone who was arrested while trying to cross one of the borders, who was trying to carry a dynamite jacket in or had it in his vehicle? Do you know if that is?
That's not confirmed right now. Do you mind me asking where you've heard that?
To be perfectly honest, it was a questionable, fishy website. Let me see if I can find it real quick, but I doubt it. But it was just a weird report, and it threw me through a loop thinking, you know, what the hell, to be honest. But
yeah, at this point, you know, we've got varying degrees of seriousness here right now, man. I mean, if I'm not the kind of guy that's down for any illegal searches and seizures, but if we've got idiots like that that may or may not, you know, be showing up to this event, I can't really blame them for kind of treating some of this the way they are right now to a degree. You know, they got to take everything at face value. So if you come in there, PDUs, hard-headed, you know, starting crap, and, you know, you're armed to the teeth, there's obviously you're going to cause yourself some problems. Anybody like that with it, fucking the capability to do what you just mentioned, obviously needs to be avoided at all costs. And I think what we should be doing is if anybody is showing up there still, that they might want to offer to volunteer to help out law enforcement to some degree, because they're going to be a better liaison to we the people than they are right now. And if they offer to, you know, maybe help out, we don't want any illegal roadblocks, but, you know, people are they're kind of saying, hey, we're looking out for each other. We just don't even really care if you're armed, you're legal, you're cool, you know, you have a right to carry from your state, so you're coming in here with open carry state. You know, if you're doing everything legal, there's not too much they can do. But if there's a jackass, you know, bringing Molotov cocktails, by all means, I hope, you know, they're arresting these assets. And you know, again, we can either confirm or deny that right now. But, you know, civilly and humanitarily, we can only say that, you know, that'd be the logical thing to do right now. I just hope it's not really encroaching on the good people's rights. And if there are any assets and Joe's headed out that way trying to cause problems, that, you know, I hope they do catch them. And I hope, the rest of these sheepdogs that are headed out there, and 3%ers and militiamen and, you know, volunteers and protesters, all kind of keep an eye out for each other. And, you know, if somebody's kind of acting in that capacity like they could, you know, be a problem, I think maybe the people could react and show that, you know, the people can handle their own. And, you know, hopefully nobody steps out of line and does something stupid. And if it were to happen, I'd be keeping an eye on the type of people that would get paid to do that. I'm not too worried about actually the hotheads doing that. I'd be more worried about, you know, I hate to bring this up as well, but, you know, similar to what kind of happened in Boston and to a different degree of whatever scale. I hope that kind of helps answer at least my opinion on that anyway.
Yeah, I was just worried that that was a legitimate story, and we don't need to be going that crazy with this. I understand the peaceful protest. It needs to be done, and I just hope that this doesn't lead to a shootout in the end. I'm hoping and praying for that it doesn't. Hope this can resolve peacefully. But, you know, more and more as it goes on and on, just seems like the tension sounds like it is more, you know, more stressful out there, and it's just getting worse. And
oh, yeah.
It's worse than me, and I know it's probably worse than everybody else here.
You know, I hope this is kind of therapeutic for a lot of people, too, as well. You know, there's a lot of people hovering over the TV and hoping for something and all over Facebook and whatnot and, you know, trying to find more data on this. And, you know, there's a lot of conjecture and a lot of hearsay and he said, she said kind of stuff that, you know, we had one loopy person earlier from this call when I said, I hope somebody from Black Bloc doesn't go through there and, you know, launch a Molotov. I meant what I said. I hope that doesn't happen. Then all of a sudden somebody else chimed in and said, oh, my God, you're telling people that, you know, Black Bloc went in there with Molotov cocktails. I'm like, no, that's not what I said. You know, we're crossing a lot of fine lines right now that we need to kind of keep everybody on the same page. So that's kind of why I'm volunteering and other people volunteer to help out. And I appreciate you, you know. I appreciate everybody else that's chimed in on this call over the last few days. And if anybody else wants to chime in, we have a couple open slots here. You can press *6 on your phone. If you've got anything to say, I'm happy to let you in. You'd be the next person on the call. Wireless caller that's still on, 7643. Anything else you wanted to add while we wait for someone else to press *6?
I'm also encouraging some local papers here to start putting the word out, because I've literally seen nothing in my area on the news-wise, especially for local, and Kern County's known to be the red splotch in the blue state, so I'm trying to encourage that as much as I can. I was a journalist by heart. I spent a couple of years in college doing that. So I'm trying to help in that form get the word out, because like another caller earlier, the EMT, I'm about finishing up a 12-hour shift doing security work, and, you know, and finding this phone number and getting a ear in on it. I'm passing, writing, taking down as many notes as I can so I can pass along some of the journalists that I know. And, you know, for at least face value, it's a contact line to be able to get, hopefully get some information around a little easier. And I'll make sure to be spreading that within my community.
Yeah, yeah. You know, please carry on as such, and you know, keep doing what you're doing, man. That's exactly what we need. You know, some more of the other warriors, Keyboard Warriors, and you know, other groups and representatives, just to keep doing that. We're trying to spread the word, find more boots on the ground, get more people on the same page. You know, add in you know, administrators and you know, other leaders and such that you know have some reach. You know, and try to get as many people as we can on the same page. If you know, we can get boots on the ground verifying, if we can get the ranchers on the phone to verify, Richard Mack and a lot of other people are aware of this phone call that plan on chiming in at some point tomorrow, you know, after they meet at the flagpole at 9 their time in the morning here in a wee bit. That's kind of what I'm looking forward to. I'm going to try to get some rest, but I got a hunch in a few hours they're going to start chiming in, so I'm going to try to get a cat nap in here in a little bit, and then you know, just continue the conversation on later. We'll definitely be going 8 o'clock central at 8 p.m., you know, later, so to speak. It's getting kind of weird because we've been doing this for a couple of days, so there's so many segmented versions of what we've recorded thus far. The playback number for this is 5726-1399, and you can hear this portion of the call by pressing pound 9762 pound. Again, that's pound 9762 pound. Should be able to play back this segment of the conversation. And in that segment, we had given out the key codes for the segment prior, so you're going to kind of be going working backwards trying to get back to the first call, but that's the best we can offer right now. Anybody's on my Facebook page, I played the second to last MP3 version of this call. You know, if you need to update yourself and see who chimed in throughout the day. I've got another person in the queue. I'm going to go ahead and move on unless you had something else to say, bro.
Oh, no, I'm perfectly fine. Thank you. Stay strong, everyone. We'll get through this eventually.
Appreciate you, man. 7643, I'm going to go ahead and open you and 0610 up at the same time. We should have two more people on this call.
Hello, brother.
Hey, what's going on, boss man?
Hey, man, this is Mark. Hey, I'm up in Palatine, Illinois. I just want to give a shout-out to you. I've been listening to you all night and appreciate the conference call that's going on.
Yeah, I've got a strange experience for you, boss. Are you familiar with the place called the Palindrome?
What's it called?
It's called the Palindrome. It's a roller rink and a swimming pool all in the same building. Does that building still exist?
I don't think so, man. No, I don't think so.
I met Alice Cooper personally when I was about 9 years old, right in that building.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah, it's small world, huh? Yeah, I went to day camp out there, man. But are you by chance in touch with your local Second Amendment group, sir?
Not locally. I'm a member of many groups on Facebook as far as 3%ers. I'm an Oath Keeper.
All right, well, you're one of the kind of guys I'm looking for. If you could do me a favor, do you have a pen handy?
Yeah, I'm driving a big truck right now. Let's see if I can pull this off. All right, yeah, go ahead.
www.IllinoisSonsOfLiberty.com.
Hold on.
I know it's a long one. IllinoisSonsOfLiberty, all one word, .com.
You got it.
Yep, there's a form at that website. You can log in through Facebook to stay in touch with the majority of the people, but once you find your county, I'm imagining you're in 2 Bravo.
Go ahead, say.
2 Bravo, I believe. Are you Cook County or Kane County? What is that? DuPage County?
Cook
County. Sorry. You actually have your own division out there. I'm in actually 2 Bravo, and I would definitely highly recommend, though, you find your Cook County on there. Go ahead and add some of those people. go ahead and add to Bravo as well, and stay in touch with some of the guys. Once you feel comfortable, there's a team designation form that we'd want you to fill out. Show up at a couple meet and greets and shake some hands with some fellows before you get to the next level. Okay.
Yeah, we'll definitely do that. I appreciate that. And your Facebook is Brian Free. What is that? Oh shit. What is your Facebook page? I'm sorry.
You were close. It was Brian with the Y, B-L-Y-A-N, and then a space,
yeah.
And type in the words "Free the People," all one word,
free
and I'll pop it up.
Yeah. Okay. I got it. I was just been riding while I was driving. It was a pain in the ass.
No, it's all right, man. I appreciate you chiming in. Did anybody else want to chime in? If you'd like to, you can press *6 right now, and you're going to end up. Anything you wanted to add, sir?
No, we'll be back with you tomorrow night, man. We drive all night long. I had a couple other guys with me on a conference call listening up to.
I'm sorry, I misunderstood. Are you heading to Ground Zero?
No, can't make it there.
Okay, fair enough. Well, feel free to chime back in if you got anything updated, man. And please, by all means, keep inviting some Patriots over here, because if you've got anybody that's got any clout, I don't care, what realm, let them know we're here trying to do the right thing and create some sort of communication. So, all right.
Roger that, man. Thank you.
Thanks for chiming in, man. We've still got, 50 some odd people on the call. If anybody else wants to press *6, that'd be great. I'm going to end up wrapping up this call in the very near future. If anybody else wants to chime in, I'm looking for you to press *6, and you'll be in the queue. Mark, I'm going to go ahead and take you off, and we just got a new wireless caller chiming in. Take care, brother. All right, wireless caller 7643, you're reengaged.
Hey, Bern. Hey, I just talked to you not too long ago, but I just came across this on, the Infowars.com. They had the Clark County Commissioner Tom Collins had stated that any Utahns that go there better have funeral plans. You heard about that?
Yeah, I actually did see that, man. There's I don't even know why he's being such an asshat right now. That's just totally uncalled for. It's totally out of line. And hopefully, if there's anybody in Utah that's been paying attention, I want you to look real hard and strong into getting that exact comment verified and on audio. And you go ahead and you find out how to put a lien on that man's bond as soon as humanly possible. You can't be making dire threats to the American people and trying to be a hotshot. You might be a commissioner, sir, but there's plenty of people waiting to stand in line to knock you over the head right now. And we're trying to avoid that. You better watch what you keep saying.
Absolutely. Yeah, and he also called them inbred hillbillies.
Yeah, you definitely need to watch what's coming out of his mouth right now. I'm trying to quell a problem, and guys like him are trying to stir the feces. I would definitely watch his intentions, who he's connected to, and what lobbyists are supporting him as well, because he's not speaking for the American people by any means right now.
Absolutely. The only ones stirring up the shit are the government people.
Yeah, exactly. So I appreciate you chiming back in, man. If you want to hang for a minute, nobody else is in the queue if you got something else to say. I'm going to go ahead and say again, if anybody wants to chime in, we got 50 people on the call. Go ahead and press *6, and I'll let you speak. But if you want to continue.
I don't know if you've been paying attention, but the whole Eric Holder situation right now, the movement to impeach him, and the Lois Lerner being held in contempt of court, a lot of stuff's going down right now in this country, and how much of this, and I've been following for, like I said, for a year and a half, 2 years, and I think they're going to do anything possible to prevent these 2014 elections to go through, because
there's a lot of smoke in there.
They know the conservatives are about to overtake.
You're 100% correct, man. There's a lot of smoke and mirrors and looking this end while something's going on in this end. That's the kind of data that we need to keep up, man. So, keep investigating what else is going on up there up high, because most likely, they're diverting attention towards this to keep our attention away from something going on in another region. And most likely it's somewhere in 10 by 10 square parcel of land called DC.
Absolutely.
You know, nobody can not agree with that if you're awake right now. But you know, if you want to take it upon yourself, you sound just as tired as I feel, bro. So if you want to go ahead and get some rest, then the early afternoon, then you know, try to hunt down more information that's going on. Maybe see if CNN's doing any live broadcasts on their second and third, just to see if there's some shady people making decisions, you know, while you know the diverted public is somewhere else right now. I would highly appreciate if somebody could take charge and do something like that.
Absolutely, I'll do that, and I'll be on tonight too.
I appreciate you, man. We'll be back about, I know I'll be back somewhere around 8 Central later. I'm getting real close to Droopy Dog Eyes right now. I've got another wireless caller that's going to chime in. If you want to go ahead and mute yourself out, bro, but I'm going to keep you unmuted on my end. So if you want to chime in here in a little bit, that's cool. But only got one other wireless trying to get in right now. So if you can hit mute on your end, I'll go ahead and keep you in the queue. And then I'm going to let this wireless caller speak. Wireless caller 5287, you're in the queue.
Hey, Brian. I've been listening for hours. My name's Taryn. I'm in Central Alabama, and I'm young, and I have way too much time on my hands being disabled right now, and I've been following a lot, and you two really hit it on the point, and I want to say you're godsent, because you have been on point and patient with all the callers, and you're a blessing. I was losing hope, because, yeah, I said there's a lot going on in the country, and it's right on TV. There's even the stuff that the president does and the executive orders that people are just calling conspiracy theories. They're not conspiracy. They're not theories. You know, it's really going to happen. And for the people that I've heard, I have hope in our country again. Because when that happened in Europe, what was it over there? When it Europe, when the 30 million people came together to get that Muslim president out of office, I wondered how many people would do that here, knowing we need to get our people out of office. And I was losing hope. And tonight, I'm going to bed with hope. And I hope you get some rest. And I was also losing hope that God wasn't in our country as much as it should be. But I've heard so many people talking about prayers. And this is a warning. What's going on right now is a sign that we have to learn from. Because all the executive orders, the reason that we can't clown is they're waiting for a reason to declare martial law. And when they do, they already said they can take our land, our cars, us. I mean, everything's already lined up. They're just waiting for somebody to clown. That's why we ain't hit the White House steps to get that bastard out of office. But I'm going to bed with hope, sir, and I hope you really get some rest, because what you're doing is amazing. It really is. Hello? Brian? Did you get cut off again? Well, I know you got cut off earlier, and if people can still hear me, I hope people learn from this and start making preparations. Because when shit really hits the fan, they already have an executive order that say they control the networks. Everything's digital now. We're not going to be able to communicate. We're going to have to be ready to join and go. There won't be no conference calls, which this is a blessing, like I said. But I hope people.
Sorry, bro, I just got cut off. I didn't mean to just interrupt you now, but I got cut off and I'm back. Keep on.
No, you're good, because you've gotten cut off earlier and I could still hear the callers, so I was still talking just to let other people know to use this as a warning and to start making preparations, because when all these executive orders go down, because they're just waiting for martial law, Brian, and you know it. That imminent, imminent domain, that's martial law. And they've already set everything up. This right here is to see how many people are going to jump. Did you hear what I said? What happened over there in Europe when that 30 million people came together to oust that Muslim president?
Absolutely.
I ask myself every day
if American people would do that.
Exactly. And just to see how many people are helping this rancher. But then I had no idea that this has already happened before, but it happened quietly. Now he's doing everything that's happening in our face. With, you know, him saying, I have a pen and a cell phone, I'll do what I want. All the executive orders has been, you know, put in with the Patriot Act. It's all been coming to a head, and it's here. But you know as well as I do, they're going to cut the networks. When shit really hits the fan, there won't be conference calls. There won't be internet. There won't be Facebook. People need to start getting ready now, because when this is on our front door, we need to be ready. They've had a long time to put this play in order. and it's something bigger. It's Satan is what it is. This is the end times, and I appreciate it for all the hope that I do have in our country right now.
Right on, man. How old are you?
I'm 34. I'm very unique, very passionate, and I'm the voice in my small little town. We're actually in the Guinness Book of World Records for the most churches per square mile. This town is, I just know I have, you know, I know I'm one of the golden soldiers, and I've been losing hope. The enemy's been attacking me because I know what I know, and I follow so much, and I pay attention, and I decipher the bullshit from the truth, and tonight is your God sent. And every one of you out there, please keep your faith and see this is a warning. God warns us. In 2001, he took our heads of protection because we are letting God disappear from our country. When people are talking about whether or not we should say Merry Christmas, something's wrong. When the president
right.
can get on TV and blatantly disrespect the Bible and praise Islam, and people, you know, people know that he needs to get out of office, but why we don't cover the White House steps? Like I said, they want us to because it's martial law. They got them plastic coffins everywhere. Jesse Ventura wasn't bullshitting. That's why they took him off, and they deleted him from my DVR. I had his shit recorded, and it was gone. People
wow.
need to quit calling it conspiracy theories and be ready. Because you know they're going to cut the networks. But right now, people can see it for what it is. And just like that man that said it was funny, man, he's so lucky I was on mute. Because there's nothing funny about this. He has a point. No, we don't know how it's going to end. But it's people like him. But that woman that came on and actually started crying and saying that she was proud to be an American, I was standing up with damn near broke back, shouting, saying, you know, amen and praise God. I mean, I haven't had that much hope in a long time. And if it wasn't for this, and God uses bad situations like what that rancher's going through to wake people up because he wants us all to come home. But people don't listen anymore. And it's all right in our face. So they're not hiding what they're doing. Nobody, I mean, how long do people raise hell when they violated our privacy? But now all you got to do is download the Facebook app and you let them activate your camera. Read the permissions. We don't
yes.
have privacy anymore. We don't have rights anymore. They know exactly. They just want to know who that they need to kill off the top, who they can brainwash, and who just don't give a damn. They're not going to kill everybody. But this is all part of something bigger. You know they've had an agenda for a long time, and I don't hate anybody, but I know the different religions, and I do believe that it has a lot to do with our president. And I know there's a lot of stuff being said on Facebook and on the internet about him, but look at what he said himself out his mouth, and look at what they believe and what they believed for years. And watch, instead of watching YouTube, watch SyriaTube and watch babies that ain't even old enough to walk calling USA pigs and swine. They're taught from the time they're born to hate us and to kill us. And then God blessed me with a personal uphand front experience with a Muslim because I had lost hope. I'd lost my job. I was homeless. And I thought, hell, all they come over here, they get new credit, a new driver's license. I went to prison young. I had kicked every opportunity in the face. So I gave up. But I was a sheep. I didn't know what Muslims was. I just knew they come over here, they get a new life. So how about I'll go over there and I'll get one. I was weeks from going to the Middle East. I married this man to get out of here. I knew him for 2 weeks, but I needed a new life. I can't start over here. They have it way better than I do. None of his stuff matched. His ID didn't match his passport. And when you get married, there's a 72-hour waiting period. But we walked in there to apply for our license, and they gave us a waiver for that 72-hour waiting period. It's like they pushed it. And then when I saw his stuff didn't match, I called him on the phone saying, I want a damn divorce, and I want it because y'all right here, how did he get past two clerks and two judges? I can't buy a pack of cigarettes with an expired ID. And I hope they're listening to me because I'm not scared of them. And I posted stuff on Facebook because if I come up dead, at least I woke up a few people. But when God saved me from that situation. But I saw what I saw firsthand those 2 weeks I was around this man. I know what they're doing. And if you look at how many of them are here, and you look at what they've been taught and what they're about, and then you look at what the president's doing and what they're taking away from us every day, this is all part of something bigger. But I know one thing, God wants us to come home, and we are the Holy Land. And I really think this is a warning, and people like you, you're an angel, Brian, and your voice is going to be needed tomorrow, so you need to get some fluids in you and some food and some rest.
I appreciate the kind words, man. It means a lot. We've got all kinds of people chiming in. You sound like a pretty spiritual cat, and I really appreciate that coming from you.
I'm actually a woman, but I smoke so many cigarettes, I sound like a guy. But
I think estrogen,
you say, you know, there's a lot of testosterone. Females are emotional, but in a different way, you know.
Well, I appreciate your heart, and that's what it comes down to. And you know,
I appreciate y'all, and I hope everybody starts talking to your friends. I know I have 600 people on my Facebook that is just local friends, not people from out of town I don't know, just my people here.
Oh. Can I chime in here?
Yeah, I'm sorry, man, we just got dropped. But go ahead, sir. You're the next caller in line. I was trying to bring two people in, and unfortunately it dropped her. Go ahead.
Cool. I was on right before her, but I just want to say I applaud her. You know, she's right on just about everything she's saying, and God bless her. But I'd like to say, you know, have you watched the show Jericho? That when Obama came in office, he immediately took off the air. Anyway, the show Jericho had so much. It was like they envisioned it before of what is actually taking place today. Now, they didn't actually detonate the nukes yet, you know, but I'm just saying, so much of that, it was true. And that in that show, they actually flew the Don't Tread on Me flag. They actually, you know, taught you the ways to prep, you know, for what's to come. And Obama came in office 08, he immediately took it off the air in the middle of season 2. And, you know, but I just want to say, also, I got something here that...
Yeah.
I'm going to read. It says, warriors are not always the fastest or strongest people. Strength and speed can be developed through training. Warriors are those who choose to stand between their enemy and all that they love or hold sacred.
Yeah, what?
You know, Brian, you're a damn warrior. So is everybody else out there.
I can't really do that.
And it's right now, you know, the Bundy Ranch, what's going on right now? You know, this is, to me, potentially the first battle of the Second American Revolutionary War. But you know what it is? It's not actually going to be a civil war. It's going to be a war against the American people brought on by foreign bankers and the elitists going for global government. The New World Order, as Bush 1 put it. You know, George Bush 1, Bill Clinton, George Bush 2, and Barack Obama all worked for the same damn company. They work for the same company. Obama is their closer. You know, and so when anybody, all these people, you know, I've heard nothing but patriots except for one or two guys on here tonight. And that one clown that called in that was laughing about this, he's just clueless. I see many people like this on message boards. I work with many people like this. I've been called, where's your tinfoil hat? You know, a fucking loony bin that needs locked up. I've been called all that. I still
have heard that a lot.
Kind of like spreading the word of God, you know. I spread the word of freedom against tyranny, you know. I don't care. Call me what you will. If I wake up one person out of the 10 that heard me talk, then I've done something good, you know. That's what it's going to take is people to share, people to talk, you know. They want us to suppress us. They want us to shut up. That's what they want. You know, and I'll do the damn opposite. And I hear a lot of, and you know, she's right. You know, hearing this tonight, you know, and I heard earlier today. I was listening to the Alex Jones show, like I said, you know, but they had this guy on. I forgot his name.
5'9".
But he said, tyranny always loses. Look throughout history; it's always lost. You know, and that's true. And it will lose again here in this country. I just hope it loses before they managed to kill millions of people like they did the Jews, like Stalin did, you know?
And
tyranny's going to lose, you know, but, you know, I saw a statistic where just registered hunters in this country with one rifle makes up 56 if you combine all the armies in the world, makes up 56 of the world armies. That is telling. You know what I mean?
Yeah, this is it right now. Go hit me up.
All right, sorry about that. I got a couple phones I've acquired since then. I'm communicating with other parts of the network. But you and me are very much on the same page based on everything that you said, man. And, you know, it sounds like we're kind of kindred in a lot of how we think. And
what I'm saying is prepare for the worst, hope for the best. You know, everybody calls in and sees daisies. Well, you know what? First of all, the first bullet that's going to be shot is not going to be the Patriots. It's going to be the damn government. But they're going to try to stage it. But listen, you know, it may not be daisies, but people need to keep it and understand and pay attention to who is trying to keep it civil, who is trying to keep it peaceful, and who just wants what's right. You know, and it ain't the damn federal government. People need to wake the hell up.
I totally agree with you, brother, and I'm going to go ahead and I gave you a lot of the floor, though. If you want to wrap that up, and I'm going to get out to a couple people's page and they waiting in line.
Yeah, bro. All right, man, you have a good night. Get some rest.
I just want to give more people a chance to talk. I appreciate you, man.
Absolutely.
Next wireless caller, 5287. He chimed in earlier. Go ahead.
Thank you, Brian. Hey, it's Terry. I was the one that you just spoke with from Alabama, and I'm going to say, I'll make it quick, I promise. But I want everybody that's listening, if you start posting stuff about the government, you usually get 30 likes on a picture of your dinner, but you only get one like about something you post about patriotism or what's going on in the government. I have 600 people on my Facebook page that is all local people, and I'm one that gets a bunch of likes on everything, but when I post about what's going on in our country, people either private message me and tell me that I need to get off drugs, or they tell me that, you know, they think about it every now and then, but they're too embarrassed to comment on it. People need to give this number. You have a thing where people can play back and listen to all this. People need to start talking to your friends at the store, at church, everywhere you go. Start saying, hey, it may not be a conspiracy theory, y'all. What if it is real? Start talking to people and getting the word out about what's going on and get this, all this that's been recorded. Let people hear it. And if they really don't care, we'll see who cares and who don't. But people need to, really wake up. There's a lot of sheep out there, and I feel for them. I want everybody to go home. I don't want anybody to have to watch their kids be raped and beheaded because that is what they do to people. And that's what, that is it not?
Read
the Quran. Yeah, I have the Bible app and I have the Quran only because I wanted to see if what I was seeing was real. Because I was clueless. I told you I married one. I didn't know what a Muslim was. He told me that I didn't have to convert from Christianity, that they like Christians. Really? Okay, I fell for that. So I know if I was a stupid sheep, then there's a lot of stupid sheep.
Hey, let me go ahead and interrupt. Hold on. Before it goes to that, let me go ahead and interrupt you. You know, I give a lot of people a chance to speak, but I do want to kind of stand up. I know a handful of Muslim people from where I used to work. I was a private contractor. I was good at what I do, and when you do a good job for someone of foreign descent, more often than not, many of them are more than willing to recommend you to other people. So,
true that, and that's why I wanted. You're right, and that's why I wanted to say it's not. Hey, it's a majority.
I'm a pretty universal guy, so I do my best to kind of get along with everybody, unless they do me wrong. I've seen live video of Christians protecting Muslims when it was their time to pray while they were in war, and I've seen
that.
That
would be amazing, but not all of them feel that way. Radical Muslims and there's Muslims. There's good ones and there's radical.
That's what needs to be said about all religions. And
I
personally look into a variety of religions, and I can't say I've found anything that I'm fully 100% confirmed, dedicated to. But, you know, there are some ways that I lean that I would like to believe were correct. But, my answer on religion is I know nobody knows what happens when you die. So anybody that says they did can kiss my ass. Because I don't believe you.
You're exactly right.
So that's kind of where I sit. And, I'm going to move on to, I got two more people on the call unless you want to say something real quick.
I'm begging you to do one thing, though. Get on YouTube and watch Obama praise Islam. Okay, there are radical Muslims and there are good Muslims, so I hope I didn't offend anybody. But I want you to watch what Obama says about Islam and watch what he says about the Bible and think about what would Satan say.
I can agree with you on that one. 773, you are back in the queue, brother. What's going on?
Hey, Brian, this is Dave again. I wanted to comment on some of the stuff that was just said by the last few people, especially seeing as on the little Paradigm Shift documentary series I do, I go into some funny detail on a lot of dichotomies and stuff. Well, the one
if you could do me a favor, I need you to hold that thought. I'm not going to remove you from the queue, but I've got one of the comms guys that just called in, and I need to put him on right now. I want you to stay online. I'm just going to put him in for a second and then see what he's got to say, and I promise you're next in line, okay?
Oh, sure, man. I'm here, and I'm streaming out to YouTube.
All right, cool. Hang on. Comms, you're on.
I'm going to get back to him. I got laughter. I was going to comment on what the previous lady had said, but just let him talk right now.
Go ahead. Speak up, man.
All right. Yeah. The one guy that was talking before, when he was talking about how, you know, the bankers control Wall Street and Wall Street controls the politicians and all that, it's the same with the organized religions. You know, if you look at what, because you know how Jesus was against the scribes and the Pharisees that were in charge? If you look at his description.
I don't know that for a fact, but I can say I know what I've read based on the testimonies of people that have rewritten a book that has been written a couple times over by people that translated it a couple times before it even made it into English, and then there was pre-English. So based on that, I can't confirm or deny anything you just said, but that's what I've been told.
Okay. Well, my simple point is that his description of the Pharisees sounds a lot like organized religion and the state, you know, people who are trying to just mess with you and control everybody instead of letting people be free. But the point is that these banksters, they hide behind religion. I personally don't think Obama's Muslim. I personally don't think the Bushes are Christians. A lot of these Jewish banksters, I don't even think are Jewish. These Kabbalists, they hide behind religion so that they can pit the religions against each other. The name of the game is divide and conquer. They want to pit everybody against each other. I got friends from all around the world, all different types of creeds and faiths and colors and everything else, and I can say that the majority of them, they're just like anybody else, just regular, basically nice people. They're being terrorized by the powers that be just like anybody. And, you know, most of these Muslims in other countries and whatever, they're just like the Christians and just like you and me and just like everybody else, just regular people that basically in their hearts are good. It's not the majority, like this lady said, that are radicals. As a matter of fact, the very extreme minority of radicals, they get put on the news as a part of the divide and conquer. Oh, look at this group of Muslim radicals. They must represent all of the Muslim faith. And, you know, people buy into it. And, you know, most Muslims, just like most Christians, they're not out to go invade and kill anybody. They're just trying to get by. And if that lady who was on the call could see how Muslim women are treated, you know, in their society by the elite aristocracy of the Islamic world, you know, I don't think that lady would be so quick, you know, to say what she's saying. Because it's pure prejudice. It's like, you know, if a black person mugs a white person and the white person's like, oh, all black people are going to mug you. No, they're not. Most black people are very nice. You've got a few miscreants, but the same as white people. It's like saying, well, most of the Nazis were white, so that must mean that, you know, all white people are Nazis. No, that's a game of the globalists. It's divide and conquer. They want to pit people against each other. And all I would suggest is don't fall for it. You know, don't fall for it.
Yeah, I appreciate your input. If anybody else wants to go ahead and chime in or give in any input, has any intel, confirmed, I'm going to go ahead and let you go ahead and press *6, and you'll fall into the queue so that we can get you ahead of everybody else that hasn't chimed in. So feel free to press *6 on your phone if you've got something to say. We want to hear from you. There's still a good 40-some-odd people on this call right now. So if anybody else wants to chime in, you're more than welcome. Got one more person that went back in the queue. Not sure how you just got muted, Huss. Let me pull you back in. Wireless caller 7643 Tom, how are you?
Yeah, I just want to comment on what the last person had to say and the divide and conquer. Absolutely, I agree. And what I was talking about by globalist elite bankers was the Rothschild family. Even Vladimir Putin himself said, you want to fix the problem, kill the Rothschilds. That's what I was referring to. And I agree with the religious aspect. That, you know, back in the 70s, Muslims didn't have all the cloaks all over their faces and heads and everything. I think that's kind of a new age thing to control the people. I agree with that. Divide and conquer. United we stand, divided we fall. That's all I had to say.
No, you're right on the money, and that's what the you know, the evildoers or the wrongdoers or the frauds up top are really trying to do. You know, when somebody's shaking their finger at you know, somebody who's doing the wrong thing, they tend to kind of try to push some blame, obviously, in other directions. So we do have some people that have chimed in that are kind of on the little project just to find out what's going on in D.C. right now, you know, directly. That's, you know, part of this sleight of hand. They're making us look one way. What else is going on around here that we need to also be paying attention to? That's usually what you want to do. And, you know, kind of like when there's a drill going on, what do? The first thing you do is you keep a close eye on what authorities are going to be showing up at this drill to see who's going to be, you know, typically instigating, you know, 7 out of the 10 last drills. We know how those turned out. And there's usually a variety of different, you know, law enforcement, quote-unquote, authorities there. No matter how fraudulent they are, when they're working in conjecture, you know, the chain of command kind of gets thrown off and the responsibility gets thrown in another area. So, you know, based on what we heard, there was other law enforcement authorities heading here. Apparently, somebody's mentioned, a few people have mentioned DHS is heading there tomorrow, while the sheriffs and politicians, hopefully more media and people with cameras and other stream capability are there. Boots on the ground to report live. I'm going to throw it up in the air for anybody else who wants to jump in on this call. There's still 40-some-odd people in the room. Anybody wants to press *6, you're going to be the next caller in line, and I'll go ahead and open the line and let you say what you want to say. Otherwise, it's going to be me and this guy at 7643 for the next few minutes, unless I can just go ahead and open up the room and scare the shit out of all y'all. Yeah, go ahead. Anything else you wanted to go ahead and say, man? I mean, it sounds like you're a logical fella and you're on the same page with the rest of us, man. Again, I like how you think, and I've met a lot of people today that, you know, I hope I can communicate and stay in touch with in the future, you know. And you're definitely one of them. I appreciate you keep chiming back in.
Absolutely. You know, I just happen to be Christian myself. You know, I'm not a very good one. But, you know, You know, I got into that watching the YouTube videos on the Muslim thing where they're beheading Christians in Syria and all that. And, you know, I got to digging deeper in that, and I noticed, you know, first of all, who was funding the Syrian rebels with all their weapons, which would be us, the taxpayers, through Benghazi. Benghazi was a gun-running place, you know, and those are just paid, you know, militants. You know, claiming to be some sort of religion, you know?
Hey, brother, I got a female that's trying to chime in. I'm still,
absolutely,
still with you. I'm just going to let this gal chime in, too, as well. Hang on, line. All right, 8692, you just called in?
Yeah, you said fucking female, dude.
Oh, sorry, bro. Hang on the line. Let's watch out for the curse words, and I see a female's name on the call already. I know exactly who this is, man, and I'm looking for chiming in. Yeah, basically we started this conversation with the Illinois Sons of Liberty commander earlier yesterday at around 7 and decided to open the doors and let other people chime in. We were trying to contact other Second Amendment supporting groups from other states and spread like wildfire from there. Many other groups and administrators from other groups and commanders and such you know, set up the call tree, and we got all kinds of media attention right now, and a variety of groups are rebroadcasting this as I speak, and other people are chiming in from all over, as well as I've seen some out-of-range calls. I'm not sure how they're getting in, but they keep coming up. I'm going to just assume that, you know, there are eyes in the sky, so kind of watch what you say right now, man. We peaked out at about 400 people earlier today, and then yesterday we only peaked out at about 130. Anybody who wants to hear the previous calls before this, you can type in your phone a phone number 559-726-1399. And audio key now for the last recorded conversation segment was pound 9676. And if you type that in and listen to the conversation along that time, we leave the number for the call prior to that one. So if that helps anybody out, I'm talking to my friend Guru on the line right now, right?
Yep, definitely.
So hopefully that could put you a little bit up to date on the call itself as far as the situation, which is what you were asking about. We've had some people that confirm boots on the ground up to around 200 people. We confirmed that the Bureau of Land Management has removed out of 500 cows, somewhere around 300-400 of them, and they're down to like 150 cows still on the property, give or take. We had somebody that had aerially came over there and counted them themselves. And now all of a sudden that whole area is in a no-fly zone. Coincidentally, we've got various communication lines that are going to be set up in the next 24 hours. As soon as I can get off this phone call, I've got to start the whole call tree up again. We've got aviators of different groups that have chimed in that want to help out. We've got somebody who had the capability to use their own personal drones, which that's going to come in useful in the near future. We've got a variety of groups that have chimed in, active military, retired, at one point ranked people, and a variety of others that we plan on coming on board for sure tomorrow, hopefully at Ground Zero or in the vicinity. We did have reports that some people were getting pulled over and they had out-of-state plates. If they're carrying weapons in a form that or a manner that they shouldn't be, we're highly recommending people not do that. The ranchers themselves just want peaceful protesters to show up. If anybody's got supplies, you're more than welcome to bring them. Bring enough to hold your own for a week or so, if possible. And if you can bring extras for others, that'll come in real handy. If you're caravanning out there, we're recommending that your munitions vehicles stay behind, if possible. And no hotheads, man. No hotheads right now. Everybody knows we're kind of on stand down, although you can go to show support. We don't need any hotheads going in there hot and heavy, full battle rattle, causing any problems. That is not what the ranchers want. And we're on their property, and right now, chain of command starts with the people at Ground Zero. Nevada has precedence, and we've got a couple of people that have been delegated to be liaisons, and they've set up a chain of command there already. And we're waiting for those people to chime back in again later today in about 14 hours.
Yeah, that's legit, man. Yeah, because I just came across on that, and then, it kind of blew my mind. I wanted to get your input on it and get a little bit more insight on it. But I was calling to the last guy that was talking, man. He was right on the head, man. One of the callers, a couple before, I didn't fully agree, or not even fully. I really didn't agree with much he had to say. But the next couple callers that called in, especially the last guy, and I was listening to him talking about the beheading and of the Christians, and I was thinking right to myself, but who funded it? And he said it right there, and wise man, dude. It's always good to come on and socialize with people that that are wide awake and outside of their bubble. But yeah, great thing, dude. You do great things, man. And I was just tuning in. I just wanted to actually just put a little insight on that, on the organized religion. It's just the same story told over and over and over and over again. Everyone, energy, science is a religion told into a different factor. Energy. Everyone has energy. That's a soul. It only can be moved on or transferred. And we all just have to get in with our inner selves and connect with everybody as a whole, man. We're all brothers and sisters from the same creator. But, somewhere along the lines, things get divided up and people point fingers at certain people. And that's exactly what he said. That's divide and conquer. That's what they want to do. That's their purpose. They want to pin us against each other create genocide, evil, and just sit back and just watch what they created. But yeah, man, that's cool. I wanted to get a little information on what was going on. I had saw your post about it, and you know, was kind of wondering. But
let me ask you this, bro. What are you doing in about 12 hours?
12 hours. Not the best at math, my man. I'm guessing that's 6 p.m. Nah, brother. Probably not a whole lot, dude.
I need you to get in contact with me around that time frame. I've got something I need to put you on. If you could clear your day from that point, I need you for a couple hours. Is that cool?
You want me to come by?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, brother, I'll come by.
All right, catch me at around 6 p.m., all right?
All right, my man.
All right, 10-4. Yep. You can stay online and all that. I got another caller that's in the queue right now, so I'm going to let them talk for a little bit. But I'm going to keep you close, man. I know exactly who you are, and I know exactly how you can help the cause, man. If you've got a couple hours tomorrow, I could definitely utilize you. Is that okay?
I got whenever you need me, brother. Whenever I'm free for you, I'm there, man.
And you know I trust you completely, man, but I'm giving you a couple promotions just because I know you, and I know where your mindset is, and I know how you think, and I trust you completely. You've not given me any reason not to, so I'm actually going to probably give you a second-in-command as far as this conference call goes tomorrow, but let's talk in 12 hours about that, okay?
No doubt, brother.
All right, 10-4, I'm going to open the line. If you get disconnected, forgive me, man. Guru, again, 12 hours from now, we got to talk. I'm going to open up the line for another person right now. 9298, are you still in the queue?
Yeah, brother, I'm here.
Go ahead, how can I help you, sir?
I'm driving in from southern Alabama. I've been on the road since about, I don't know, about 2:30 yesterday afternoon, somewhere near Oklahoma now. Where do we need to go? People that are coming in, people that are driving that away from across the country, where are we needed, what are we needed to do, where do we need to head to?
You know, we're trying to find some rally points. As far as we know, Ground Zero is still open, and the the ranchers are requesting that at 9 o'clock their time this morning, in a few hours, that they meet at the flagpole on their property. And I, you know, again, we're trying to get boots on the ground, waiting for them to wake up. It'll start getting bright around there real soon. So hopefully somebody else chimes in and can bang that out for you. I would highly recommend any sort of navigation tools or equipment that you have to get to that Bundy Ranch via Google Maps or whatever it is. You know, you go right ahead, but don't come in hard and heavy, man, if you can. As of right now.
Let me tell you a little bit about myself and what we're trying to do. I'm a United States Army SEER School instructor. I'm a civilian contract instructor for the United States Army SEER School. I also run a Facebook page called American Warrior Revolution. Man, we're strictly, there's several of us that are coming. We're coming because we want to put out some high-quality instruction to the people that are there, just training and simple stuff. And, man, we're not coming into, we just want to be supportive. We want to pass some of our knowledge to those that are willing to accept it and just help in any way we can. You know what I'm saying? There's several of us that are coming from the SEER school. Just want to help, you know what I mean? So we're coming in with, you know, kind of blind as far as where we're needed to go or what we're needed to do. I've heard some stuff about people congregating or meeting at one of the tribal areas. I don't know if that's still on, or I've got a phone number to, I guess, get a hold of them. But,
you know, one person called in and recommended that, said that they spoke to someone in the office just before it was closing and said that they have offered that. I don't know that exact situation. I would still consider trying to get that as a rally point.
Okay.
As of right now, that was a dedicated rally point number one, but we don't have anything totally confirmable until we can get a hold of them when they open, and it is the weekend, so I'm not sure what their hours are. We'd like to get a hold of them. If anybody can catch anybody from the res that can maybe go to someone in charge at the res and verify that, that'd be huge right now. So if and when you get there, I would actually
still recommend trying
to open those doors. And if you are in contact with more boots on the ground, please get them in on this call because we need live people that are there on the inside of the circle I'm just going to recommend, you know, no BDUs if you're coding in a caravan.
No, we're all civvies, and we're not gonna represent ourselves, you know, as Army contractors. Again, we're civilian. We're not enlisted in the Army. We're civilian contractors for the Army, but that's not what we're here to do. We're just here to pass out some instruction and give some training to those who are wanting it, and help in any way that we can. Is it okay if I publish the ad for this conference call on American Warrior Revolution?
Absolutely. You've got full reign to rebroadcast it, to repost it, request, you know, other people to repost it, however you want to go about doing that. We are fully open to that idea. We want active duties. We want more veterans that are in touch with active duties to kind of keep us posted on, you know, what are you guys thinking over there? We know that I know a lot of veterans, man, and I work with a veteran business run by veterans, and all of our clients are pretty much veterans, and a lot of active duty that we're in touch with. So a lot of them have chimed in over the last 2 days, and we want to hear more from guys like that. Also, just to get some feedback, we know that people are at a point where they know that they may have to choose sides, and we want to make sure that we get as many people on board, you know, to let them know that they're not alone, so other people that are going to choose the right side, which is really the people, no matter how you look at it, and doing the right thing, that's all we want. That's the American way it should be. You know, we know who the infiltrators are now. You know, we know who the bad guys are now. And, you know, it's kind of sad. It's kind of exposed. You know, it's really unfortunate that, you know, things are coming down to what they are coming down to. This is a potentially volatile situation, which is totally what we're trying to avoid. All I can, you know, say is we're still trying to get a lot of surrounding sheriffs on the same page. If anybody can still try to reach out to surrounding county sheriffs and get some feedback or let them know about this call so they can chime in or at least come back with what that sheriff might have said, that'd be huge. So we still got 50-some-odd people on this call. You know, if somebody can help coordinate that, that'd be great. I'm going to let you talk in one more second. I'm just going to remind – hang on a second. I'm just going to remind people, if you're still on this call and you're one of those 50 people and you want to speak up, have anything to say, any updates, I see some names that have not come forward, you know, feel free to press star 6 right now, and you'll be able to chime in. But